Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages. Welcome to a brand new episode of VWF Nitro. This is yours truly, the jam back to Joseph Atos. And as Ashley Simpson is making her way to the ring right now, going to face an unknown opponent, somebody who she was talking to Fred about something last week, and Fred had an opponent in mind, but unfortunately he did not tell me who it is. Hell, I wish I did know who it was. Ashley Simpson has been dealing with a lot for that whole, I don't think she has to worry about anybody trying to take her opinion out of briefcase anymore, even though she better hurry up and cash that sucker in before VixenMania 2, because if she doesn't do it by VixenMania 2, well, it's null and void. You would have had the case for no reason, not been able to do anything. All right, who is she gonna wrestle? Son of a bitch. Why is she still here? How much money did she bribe Fred to keep her job? That's what I'm wondering also. The show McCool has been on in a while. She tried like a couple times to steal people's spots. Tried to start a lot of problems with people and she still ended up getting destroyed. Oh my god. Is Mike threatened by the fact that she's married to The Undertaker? Could that be why she's still here? Like, he's afraid that if he were to fire her, then Mark and Undertaker would just come in, he'll kick the door down and beat the hell out of him. I don't know, I have a feeling that could be it. There's one thing I could possibly think of for this. Tune-up match! Yeah, I have a feeling this is gonna be a tune-up match. Or I could be wrong. But anyway, let's find out. Showgirl going with Bulldogs. Caught Ashley off guard. Ashley thought she would try to get the easy win. It ain't gonna be that simple in the early going. I may talk a lot of crap about Michelle McCool, but she does know how to wrestle to some degree. Knee, and Ashley responded with a Bulldog. We had like multiple Bulldogs being used so far. Oh god, Yurikhead spinning backhand. Michelle McCool kick to the back of the knee. Right, no way, front. That stroke. I'm surprised nobody in the crowd had one. Judge Jarrett will be pleased. And Michelle McCool has Ashley Simpson trapped in the corner. No, Ashley throwing Michelle McCool in the corner. No, it would now vice versa. Trying to control the positioning in the corner. No. Wait, no. Michelle McCool countering with an overhead belly-to-belly suplex. And ladies and gentlemen, VixenMania 2 is close. Very, very close. We're almost there to the grand stage. The grand spectacle of them all. Hell, even as Usagi continues with her struggle to even make it, as Abdallah has been, you know, playing psychological warfare with her, using her friends to try to weaken her for reasons completely unknown. Oh god, front suplex. So our Michelle McCool has been taking control of Ashley. I don't know how this is possible. Also, guys, tonight we have another Queen of the Mountain qualification match. Yuna and Rikku will be going at it tonight for a spot in the Queen of the Mountain match, VixenMania 2, to get that case and try to get their dreams to come true if they even get it. Ashley Simpson double knees to the shoulders of Michelle McCool, now dropping the elbow right to the back of the head. For Ashley, retaking control of this match. This has been a very strange season for Ashley. She's somehow gotten multiple title shots, lost almost all of them. She's been buried a lot. She was actually, you could probably say she was the first victim of Gina Carano way back earlier in the season. I'm surprised she even has the case still. Then again, if you have that kind of resolve, you can basically overcome anything. Kick to the back, right to the back. And just as I thought Ashley Simpson was taking control, Michelle McCool is like denied. Oh, flapjack. That ain't gonna help matters. Yeah, front face lock. Oh, kick to the back of the knee. So Ashley Simpson had a kick in her knee. that could be like the opening with Show McCool needs. Clothesline from the corner. Show McCool somehow beating Ashley Simpson. I don't know how this is possible. One, two, no, only two count. Majobber trying to overcome Ashley Simpson. Once again, another kick to the back of the knee. And now, once again, working on the shoulders. Just driving those elbows into him. Ashley brought back down to earth. Now, a lateral press, here we go, cover. One, two, no. Oh my God, I would have been upset if Michelle McCool would have beaten Ashley Simpson. I think her pride would literally be hurt. Or, maybe I could be wrong. Wait, Ashley gonna try to go for GZS? No, reverse DDT. Show who caught that from a mile, saw that from a mile away, and oh no. Oh God, please no. Please don't let it be what I think it is. Oh, no, it's time. We're relief. Ashley just saw it counter that drop kick. Now wait, they're over the back of the head. And the crowd is not pleased. And then he went to complete 180-0. She tried to go in for the favorite. No. Ashley Simpson will not get put away like that. She's like, this is my tune-up match, not the other way around. Oh, back visor all the way to the outside. Now here they are, right by my broadcast position. Muay Thai knee to the face. Oh God, they're right at my table? This is not good. Maybe I should talk to Fred about giving me my own skybox. Now, scoop slam right here on that concrete floor. That ain't padding, ladies, though. That is concrete. I respect those who use padding, but, you know, who needs it? That may throw back in ring. Michelle Cole left choking the daylights out of Ashley Simpson. Gotta get back in that ring. You know, like an SCA VW also has 20 counts. Oh, God. Kick right big boot to the face. Instead of capitalizing, she's basically taunting. Not a good idea. Lifting her up. No. Knee to the head. Ashley Simpson getting herself out of that jam. And oh, you might as well ring that bell right now, referee. Anaconda Vice. The Anaconda. The Anaconda. She's got it locked in. She was struggling a little bit to keep it locked. But she's got it in now. And Michelle McCool is trying to fight out of this as much as possible. She's trying to loosen that grip. But no. It is over. It was over the moment it got put on. Michelle McCool struggled for a little bit, trying to keep Ashley from locking on tight. But as soon as Ashley got control of it, it was already over. Let's see the highlights here. Extreme replay. Showed through one of the earlier near falls. Over that suplex and unfortunately knee to the head. I tell you, man, you will respect that knee because the knee is a powerful move. Had her locked in that Anaconda Vice. That was it. It was over and done with. And Ashley Simpson victorious in this tune-up match. Now she can concern herself with VixenMania and guard the briefcase for dear life, because I got a feeling someone will have to. This is the last time anybody will go after that cooling metal case and take it from her. sort of crap I ever heard in my life. What we're going next is our next Queen of Metal qualifying match, as Yuna will be taking on Rikku. Former tag team partners and friends, sworn rivals, though Yuna's gotten the better of most of their battles. But, oh my god. Before I go into what we just seen, Yuna making her way to the ring. Yuna, we haven't seen her in a while, former VWF Intergalactic Champion. But she's going to be taking a break and trying to get the Intergalactic, get back her belt. Decided to go for something a little bit more productive. Going to try to go for that Queen Mountain. Going to try to qualify to go to VixenMania and get the case. But still, jeez. Man, Abdallah once again trying to use psychological warfare. And I can't believe she has Usagi fighting Makoto again. And now the stipulation, and this is the one thing that kind of annoys me, is she's changing the rules as she goes. If Usagi loses later on tonight, then that means that all three of them are going to be at ringside. That's like the biggest handy, that would be considered the biggest handicap match in VW history. I'm hoping to God that Usagi's able to change her fate with this. As Yuna's cousin Rikku is making her way to the ring. Man, these two former tag team, the Gold Wings. Though Yuna had that change earlier in the season. Trying to go into this as a singles wrestler. And Rikku's been trying to beat some sense in Yuna, but unfortunately, that has not worked. Unfortunately, that has not happened. It's been the other way around. Rikku has been destroyed by Yuna. Hell, who knows? Maybe Rikku's lucky. Maybe she could probably get a win off of Yuna tonight and qualify for the Queen of the Mountain match. Only one way to find out, and as soon as that bell rings. Here we go. Rikku and Yuna facing off, stare down. Gotta wonder who will make the first attack. Blocking each other's strikes. And it's Yuna who has the better of the exchange. Yuna has gotten the most wins out of these encounters between herself and Rikku. You gotta wonder, how is Rikku gonna overcome this? Oh, able to dodge that. And guys, remember, VixenMania 2 is in 3 weeks. In 3 weeks' time, the biggest show VW history will be coming to a computer near you, on your phone near you, on your Xbox near you, if you're watching this on Xbox. You know, throwing Rikku on the apron, no. And Rikku in it. Oh no, Yuna had that well scouted, and dropping the elbow right into the back. Yuna's gonna have to be a little bit more cautious, and have to plan her attacks a little bit more. She's going to try to do some stuff to the damage to Yuna. Rikku's dead set on trying to beat some sense into Yuna. But at the same time, she gets a shot at the Queen of the Mountain at VixenMania 2. Match of an opportunity. Dream. To get that case. And this is good for those who aren't really, you don't really see commonly trying to get a shot at the VW belt. So are Rikku getting the better of these exchanges with Yuna here at this portion of the matchup? She needs to try to find an opening and try to make sure she keeps that control. Because Yuna just took control back and now got control in the corner. Wait, positioning her near the corner sneak eyes. Wait, right on that turnbuckle. Rikku should be fortunate that turnbuckle ain't exposed, because if it was exposed, it probably would have been a lot worse than it already was. Rikku kitchen sink to move right to the stomach. If there's any place you don't want to get hit, and that's in the stomach. Now Hurricane Rana, you see Yuna holding onto her back a little bit. Grabbing her by the hair, dragging her to the center of the ring. Fallen, that definitely rocked her a bit. She got her in the corner, no. Oh, Rennet once again, Rikku able to hold on. But Yuna's gonna try to suplex her back in the ring, and she does. She wants to make sure that Rikku doesn't try anything slick. So Riku's getting her Yuna right when her guard is dropped. And she's exploiting that, she's using it and exploiting it. Yuna left her cell open for this exchange. Kick to the stomach. And wait a minute. Sunset flip. Oh no, she didn't hook the waist. Didn't get that pin. Always gotta try to hook up that, go for that pin whenever you have the chance. Even if they were to kick out in one, it does require, they are spending energy kicking out. And Rikku definitely getting control. She's definitely got Yuna. Oh no. Oh, wait a minute. Oh, Yuna had back body dropped her to the apron. And dropping her to the outside. Yuna now in pursuit. Why isn't the ref counting? That's like the longest one count, ref. Frank needs to talk to these referees. Now Yuna delivering headbutt. And I'll kick you right in the right around the bridge in the nose. And the referee's at four. Now Yuna sending Rikku back in the ring. That's somebody else playing elbow to the right to the bridge of the nose. Going for a cover. I don't know if that's going to be enough to put her away. Two. No. Two count, but it was damn well close. Oh, God. I heard that from here. And I'm just driving her knee right into the face. Just trying to suffocate her with it. Rikku shoving her waist some distance. Oh, I got baited right into a Manhattan drop. No, Rikku countering. Knee. DDT. Rikku beginning, or at least trying, to turn this around. She had that control earlier in the matchup. Let's see if she can try to get that control back. Maybe we can see Rikku finally get a victory off Yuna. Corner. Once again, kick to the midsection. I think she's going to try to go for the sunset flip again. And she does. She's got that waist locked. One, two. No. Oh, man, that was so close. That was definitely close to a three. We could add our next qualifier. Elbow. It's just takedown. Up the top rope. Yuna. Tried to drop that fist. And unfortunately, Rikku was able to get out of the way. You see Yuna holding onto her hand. That did a lot more damage than I thought it would. And the Albed drop. The Albed drop. That depth, if there was any way to catch Yuna with that, it was right then and there. And that could be it. And no. I don't know how the Yuna was able to survive that. Yeah, I wonder how her fist is feeling right now. She could have broke her hand if she wasn't careful. Trying not to let this deter. And a big, oh! Tried over to Frog Splash, but no, Yuna was able to get out of the way. Tactical evasion. A little showing off, but Rikku's still trying to keep on the offense. She's trying to force Yuna on defense. And Shatter Spear! And Yuna out of nowhere, connecting with the Shatter Spear, and that could be all she wrote. One, two, no! Now that was survival in the fit of it itself. Both kicked out of their signature attacks. The Yuna not panicking, not deterring. She's staying on offensive and trying to keep the pain coming in. And the hell, Melina? What is her business being out here? She has no business out here. This doesn't even concern her. Melina now lurking around the ring for like completely unknown reasons. And another Shatter Spear by Yuna. And that could be all. That could be it. Yuna with the cover. Oh, you have got to be kidding me. Melina, who is happy for Yuna. And Yuna's pissed. Oh, wait, oh. Yuna is going right for Melina. And now Melina. Sending Yuna right through the right in the steel steps. I don't know if Rikku planned this or not, but Yuna's completely snapped and is going after Melina. She better remember her opponent is in the ring, and Rikku taking advantage of Yuna being distracted, bring her right back in the ring. And Melina's still out there. You gotta say that. Oh god, another Owlbed drop. One, two, and no. Yuna even survived that. Yuna is one who doesn't know when to quit. Oh wait, no, reversing that. Picking her into a rib breaker of her own. She wants to break the ribs of Rikku. Most likely want to break the ribs of Melina as well. And Melina, I think she left. Yuna's got Rikku on the corner. And for the most overused move in professional wrestling, the superplex. You know, wait a minute. Now she undoes does the turnbuckle add. And wait a minute, inside cradle. Rikku with an inside cradle. One. No, only one. That would have been an upset if Rikku was able to catch Yuna off guard like that. I don't know if she'll get another opportunity to bank that again. Aiming for the back of the knee. And a clothesline. Oh, wait a minute. Diving headbutt of death. Rikku feeling it. Oh, no. Yuna was able to get herself out of that one. I don't know what Rikku was going to try to do there. Rikku with exchange, with getting caught in Yuna's exchange of strikes. Spinning heel kick. Bringing Yuna back down to earth. What could Rikku do to possibly try to keep Yuna down? Oh, God. I heard that, man. I heard that. Bulldog. Yuna's down. If Rikku's gonna try to go for anything, now would be the time. And, oh, how is she? It's amazing how Yuna's able to quickly recover. One, two. That was amazing about Yuna. Yuna always had, somehow always made the quick recovery. It's like she has a fast recovery rate. I mean, what? Did she cast Autolife on herself before the match? That could be a guess, in my opinion. She casted Autolife. Either that or casted Protect on herself three times in order to overcome all this damage, all this punishment. And Rikku, oh, right into the exposed turnbuckle. And Yuna now is going to use this for full advantage. And, oh no. Oh god. Shatter Spear level 2. And Yuna barely uses this. One, two. Oh, forget about it, it is over. Even with the interference, it was not enough to stop Yuna. Rikku tried and literally legitimately tried to beat Yuna. But unfortunately, it did not happen again, even with Melina's interference. Heard one of the near falls a couple minutes ago. But this over here, ladies, so this is endgame. The Shatter Spear level 2. That was not pretty. And yeah, Rikku is not getting back up in this. So now, Yuna is our next third-pin qualifier for the Queen of the Mountain. The former Intergalactic Champion wants better gold. Hey, yeah, wonder who else is left for the qualify? Yeah, I agree with that sign. He's like, referee, get him! I'm gonna celebrate. Uh-oh. It's Fred. He don't look too happy with them. It's punishment time. It is the opening once again of the Gina Carano Federation. The GCF is open and ready to bury people. Not for real. She should make her own hotline and be like, this is Gina Carano, and who do you want me to bury today? We already have our local athlete already picked out from the get-go. This is hilarious. Kiki is the next victim. Viola was a victim, and now Kiki was a victim, even though both of them had been buried at the same time in handicap matches. So this is dead woman walking. Here comes Kiki. One half of the VWF Tag Team Champions. Come out solo. I wonder if that's really a smart thing, not have Viola in her corner. Then again, it probably wouldn't make a difference. This is a really harsh punishment. I find this really hilarious. This punishment is so harsh. It kind of reminds me how when JTG last was speaking out about something, and WWE was not happy about it, and they put it against Brian that is a punishment. That's what this reminds me of. Gina already staring at her meat. She's starting. And here we go. You know, guys. Lightning tried. I find it funny how Lightning was trying to attack Aerith. But she's on TV. She's like, damn, I'm going to have to wait. But still, there has to be this investigation with this thing with the Abdallah and the contaminated life stream. There's got to be something. Like, Ruin, what could have been so powerful to contaminate the life stream like that? And then thinking about Abdallah's connection with it. I don't know, something is not adding up. I've been trying to find the answer to this thing myself, and it's been difficult, because most of the clues, every time I find a clue to something, it just leaves you with more questions rather than answers. I have some feeling of what it could be, but I'm not sure if it will be right. But for now, I'm going to go to the match. Don't worry, guys. I'm gonna try to find the answer to this somehow. If Aerith can't come up with one. And Kiki's trying to go for an ankle lock. That was a really an effective ankle lock. I highly doubt he even heard Gina. Gina eats those for breakfast. I don't even think Gina even ate breakfast earlier. You know, she's locked up in her cage. I saw the bones in the cage, man. It was horrible. Shoved into the at the apron. No, Gina, not letting that happen. I have no idea what advice I can give the Kiki about what to do against Gina Carano. I think the only thing I can say is don't get caught in a submission. I think that's like the only real advice I can really give, because you know Gina Carano has like destroyed like most of the roster, and it feels like Gina's like unstoppable, invincible. You know, I still find it strange how she declined Tifa's challenge. Then again, if you have a winning streak like this, you wouldn't want anybody trying to take your spot away. Still, Gina hasn't defended the Intergalactic title in a while either. Another thing I noticed. And Kiki tried to do something, anything, to keep the advantage or to stay in control. She's taking high risk. She's trying to do any means necessary, even getting out of her game plan to do something against Gina. You're going to need to come up with heavy, critical shots if you want to do anything to Gina. And so Kiki has been controlling the pace right now, has been giving Gina some difficulty. But yeah, I wonder how long that's going to last. Leg on the rope. Reverie. The leg is on the rope. And no. Oh, what a... That was a powerful thrust kick. That should send Gina a little bit of distance. Watch out for submissions. Neckbreaker. And Gina, once again, taking back that control. It doesn't matter how long you try to keep control of the match. Gina has to do like one real move or a strike, and she'll take the control right back. You'll be more worried about what is she going to do to you next, rather than trying to defend yourself against him. And that's exactly what Kiki's experiencing right now. And something tells me that the end has come. The end has come. Body scissors. Body scissors. Running a choke. She's got it locked in. Can Kiki survive? Oh, wow. She actually is doing what Harley Quinn did. Biting on the wrist. She was biting on the hand and wrist of Gina. And she saved herself. But yeah, I wonder how long is she saved if she gets caught in that again. Oh, damn, that was close. He would have gotten the upset of the century. If that would have been a three count. I mean, now technically, I would have said Jessica Simpson would have beaten Gina, because she did technically make Gina tap out. Or was it Harley? I can't remember. Somebody made Gina tap out, but the referee wasn't able to see it. Now, Kiki going back up top. In position. And I don't know whether that really, if she hurt herself or did more to Gina. He showed off that arrogance. You know, if you got Gina down, that's a rare thing to keep Gina down like this. And no, wait, never mind. He brings her back down. And misses my favorite move, the leg drop. And now, what is she going to try to go for here? And, oh, come on, Kiki, you can do better, think better, a little better than that. And Gina taking full advantage of the opening and went right for some punches. Oh, God. Something tells me, this ain't going to end well. Nothing's worse than having your arm, your legs, all being stretched out like this, and you might as well ring that bell, referee. Kiki got nowhere to go unless she finds a way to power her way out of this. And don't forget it, it is over. Gina has buried Kiki Dewynter. Oh man, that didn't take too long. Kiki's only saving grace was the time when she avoided the body scissors, the sleeper, by biting on the hand and the wrist. But even with that still was enough. Let's see this kick that she did to Gina. Ooh, big roundhouse kick. There's loud press. That was almost a three. No lie, that could have been upset of the century. But then, when Gina had this locked in the middle of the ring, oh, forget about it. How Kiki was able to quickly recover, I have no idea. Wait, I'm wondering, what is this surprise? Let's go to the Hall of Justice. What's Freddy gotta say? What? Against Jill Lara again? Unification? Kinda wonder what belt would be the real tag team championship belts from whoever wins. But I think the Dewynter Sisters would probably have. Wait a minute, there's Jewel right now! And Kiki and Yuna quickly, tactical retreat. We gotta wonder if the Dewynter Sisters would probably have a better advantage, because remember, they've gotten the better of Lara and Jill. Maybe with the high stakes like this, maybe Laura and Jill can take those tag team titles and bring the real tag titles to VWF. It's a trap! Yes! 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 Lightning finally got her chance. Now she can go and say, yep, I got it. Now I can relax. Now, guys, it's time for the main event time. Usagi now must face Makoto again. And with the win, with an even worse stipulation than the last feud, if Usagi were to lose, Makoto, Minako, and Rey are going to be at Abdal's Corner at VixenMania 2. That's even worse. And here comes Makoto. I see that mark on the side of her face is starting to develop even more than normal. That must be, I can guess, that could probably be the traces of the dark energy that Aerith was talking about before Lightning basically shoved it. I love it. Anyway. So at least we got another clue to the dark energy. Someone, Abdal had to got those powers from somebody. Gotta wonder who was it that gave, who gave her the dark power. Who would have thought that Abdal would be this desperate to try to get a new body? I would have figured she would have tried to find other ways, or even hell, even use some of that dark energy she's got to keep her herself in Ami's body. But it seems that with Ami regaining back parts of her humanity and getting more control, Abdal's defenses are probably cracking from within. But still, it could be very dangerous if she were to get her hands on Usagi's body. This is some Dragon Ball Z type thing, I don't know. That's what the first thing has me thinking. You know, there could be other things. Usagi's gonna have to watch her back. Abdal's right there. Right out there. She can basically attack her whenever she wants. Alright, here we go. The psychological mind games continue. Right now they're just briefly staring at each other down. You see Abdal lurking around outside the ring like a snake. Just waiting for the moment for Usagi to drop her guard and then strike. Usagi's gotta be very cautious. Makoto may have aerial ability, but within the Senshi, she's pure power. Pele didn't work. Usagi a little hesitant. She's wondering, what can I use to get the first blow? She's wondering, why isn't Makoto going for the first attack? She's drawing her in. That was pretty smart. Trying to bait herself. No, Makoto wasn't able to time that one correctly. And now Usagi delivering series of clotheslines. Lutez press, delivering two concentrated punches to the jaw. And you see Abdal on ringside. waiting for the opportunity. She wants Usagi to try to hit her, get herself intentionally disqualified. That would basically be saving Dollar the trouble, and already had that handicap to happen. It's gonna be very hard for Usagi. She's gotta fight Makoto while at the same time watch her back, because Abdallah's like right there. And Sarah Makoto is overwhelming Usagi with power moves. Oh, Usagi will avoid the drop kick. And Sarah will. Abdallah's trying to grab her. Usagi was quickly able to get out of the way. She's gotta avoid the edges of the ring. Avoid being near those ends. Doll is going to try to pull something. I just know it. So, no, wait, Makoto. Tornado DDT. See, Usagi holding her head a little bit. Makoto with the Muay Thai knee, upsetting Usagi, pulling her back. Oh, God, into a hurricane run. And Abdallah, once again, you see her on ringside, distracting Usagi, leaving her open to these attacks. Oh, man, that was definitely almost a three. Usagi would have had the unfortunate situation of what would happen in VixenMania 2. Usagi's gonna try to has to overcome all this if she wants a fair fight with Abdallah in VixenMania. That's gonna be a little easier said than done. I mean, come on, what's to say that even if Usagi were to win these, what's to say that they wouldn't be in her corner anyway? Abdallah's that cheap. Now go DDT in the leg. Looks like things for Usagi aren't going as the way they did the last time these two fought. Usagi dazed. She's trying to get back up to her feet. Oh God, front missile dropkick from the corner as Usagi was sitting down. And now picking her up. Backdrop bottom, and this is not looking good at all. This could be, I don't know, could this be it too? No. Usagi trying to fight fate. Trying to fight. And what makes this even worse than things already are is that there aren't that many people to back Usagi up during this time of crisis. Or there would be, but some wouldn't have the guts to help her. The leg is hooked. One, two, no. Hits Makoto with a hit toss. Makoto overwhelming Usagi. Usagi hasn't been able to do anything. Look at the strength. Look at the pure power. And literally just drops her down. Getting some distance. Drop kick to the side of the head. The leg is hooked. No. Usagi able to kick out before one. Finally getting some offense in, getting that dropkick. You see her holding onto her ribs. Spinning heel kicking Abdallah, once again lurking. She's trying to grab Usagi. She's dead set on it. No, wait, Makoto. Trying to go for a jumping savate kick. No, Usagi able to avoid it. Dragging her away from the end of that ring. Wait a minute, we got her. Come on, she's got the leg hook. One. No, Makoto with the reversal. One. Reversal. One. Kick out. Usagi trying to use other tactics to get herself out of this mess that she's in. Bulldog. And Abdallah just lurking. Just waiting. Kick to the back of the knee. Slamming her down, and now things are going Usagi's way. She needs to do something to keep the control, make sure it stays there. And, oh wait, never mind. The eye have been poked. The great equalizer. And Usagi somehow still surviving. I gotta call Usagi like the Senshi survivor. Because you know when her teammates fall to something like this, you know Usagi somehow is going to be the only survivor. Oh, wait a minute. She's got her. The Moon Clash! The Moon Clash! The waist is locked! And son of a bitch! I had a feeling Abdal was gonna pull this. I definitely had that feeling Abdal was gonna pull some crap like this. Gonna make sure Usagi, she's gonna try to get Usagi to lose by any means necessary. And wait a minute, Usagi with the reversal. Wait a minute, it's German! And Abdal is not pleased. You see, I can see it in her face. She's raging. Back. Now, one. Two, slamming your head into the turnbuckle. Trying to do something, anything to try to weaken Makoto. But at the same time, she has to worry about Abdal. And Usagi with the moonsault. And another moonsault. And I think she's going to try to moon clash again. That could be the case. Hold on, she's going to try to moon clash a second time. And it connects. But she did not hook the waist. She knows that Abdal is right there. Oh, wait. Oh. Abdal quickly retreating. I know she's not stupid enough to try to get herself disqualified. Wait, wouldn't that be a disqualification? Oh my god, the referee did not make that disqualification. That can't be good. We saw he was so close to tapping. She's trying to fight out of this. She's trapped in the abdominal stretch. Remember, her ribs have been worked on a lot in this match. And she's able to hit toss her way out of it. Yeah, I don't know how much strength, how much energy that had to take to get Makoto off her. Go right behind, hooking that waist. No. Trying for a knee, but unfortunately that did not work out. Slap, slap, spinning heel kick. Usagi staying strong, fighting and staying strong. This woman has no ounce of quit in her. Wait, but Abdal is down. This is Usagi's chance. This is Usagi's chance to try to end this. Moon clash. The waist. One. And damn it. Abdal with her quick recovery. Makoto shifting the weight. No. Usagi keeping that waist locked. And damn it. With the referee's distraction, Usagi could not get that cover she needed. I have no idea. Abdal is probably, most likely, he's probably still lurking. Or the referee kicked her out. And Usagi going with the crossbody. And you see Abdal raging. She's raging. She might rage quit. Kick to the knee. Once again. Abdal being that cheating snake. And don't wait. Oh, man. Vicious jawbreaker. And what is she now? Makoto going up top. And she wants Usagi up to a vertical base. Knees! Those knees will be respected. And then the moonsault? No. Usagi setting Makoto up for a ride. Clothesline. Dropping here to the outside. Usagi should use this time to recover. Stay away from the outside of the ring, and Usagi would ignore my advice and go for high risk. And now she's going after Abdal, sending her into the bear game. She's taking advantage of the fact that Makoto is down, and now she's going to go beat the hell out of Abdal. But I might be short-lived. Makoto's back up. She's going to try to go for a moon clash on Abdal. No, Abdal countering to an arm drag. In the barricade. They're loving every minute of this. Into the steel. Oh, man. Into the steel. Into the steel post. And now back in the ring. Now Usagi's definitely in trouble. And oh my god, the fight of Jupiter. And another one. One, two, no. Usagi survives the flight of Jupiter. I thought that was going to be over. And Makoto's still staying on Usagi's, delivering all these punishing blows. Usagi going with evasions. Trying to soften Makoto up, and so far it's working. And Abdallah once again being the snake that she is, lurking at ringside on that apron. Once again, Usagi distracted by Abdallah. And Makoto taking advantage of those openings. But Usagi, now they're just exchanging shots. And oh wait, now putting her down. Usagi trying to get up. You saw her, she had trouble. Now they're like in a sleeper and just slammed her down. Kick to the spine. I think Abdallah's been objected. Rejected, I mean. Why would I say object? Yeah, she is. She's gone. And oh no. But that could be short-lived. You could be seeing an MKO surprise. Oh no. I was right. The MKO! The MKO! And that could be all. And no. Usagi somehow getting back up to a vertical base. Wait a minute. She rolled up. She's got a victory roll. Victory roll. One, two, three. She did it. Usagi overcame another of this redemption series. Even with Abdallah's constant interference, Usagi was able to hold strong. Talking about overcoming the odds. I think as soon as Abdallah was rejected, I think that's when Usagi, that was definitely Usagi's chance. Oh, wait a minute. Makoto and Usagi are still going at it. And Abdallah, Usagi, look out. A coming blow to the back of the neck. And now they're both wailing on her. Is there anyone who can try to put a stop to this? Wait a minute. Surprising is Haruka and Mashiro. Haruka and Mashiro coming to the rescue. And they chase Makoto and Abdallah out of here. Kind of strange. These two hate Usagi with a passion. Why would they help her? I have no idea. We'll have to find out next week. Guys, this is yours truly, the J-Vac, saying good fight, good night, and I'll see you guys next week for another episode of Nitro.